Got a call from Joe telling me it was time to settle the European flat oyster larvae. European flat oysters are also called Belon, and it's a native oyster of Europe. Interestingly, it's actually closely related to our Olympia oyster. Quickly, I headed to the UC Davis Bodega Marine Laboratory in Bodega Bay, California. We're going to rush inside to the oyster hatchery. I wish I had time to give you a tour of the lab and show you this awesome rockfish aquarium, but Joe's already starting to empty the tank of the oyster larvae. We got here just in time. As we shine a light into the culture tank, you can see millions of larvae swimming around. We know they're ready when the larvae start settling to the bottom of the tank and begin probing the surface with their foot to find a substrate to attach to. While Joe is busy emptying tanks, we need to ready the downwellers and fill our sumps with phytoplankton. When you have an oyster hatchery, you better be good at farming microalgae to feed your oysters. Once we've filled our buckets, Sam will make sure there's enough food in each of the downwellers. We also want to make sure that there is plenty of oxygen in the downweller. The aeration also serves to mix the microalgae and keep it in suspension. A downweller is designed for water to gravity flow down through the system, in this case, a sieve. Oyster larvae will be needing substrate to attach to, but in a downweller, you would use a variety of sizes of crushed shell. We're going to use a fine powdered shell. Hard to believe that each grain of sand will end up supporting a single oyster larvae. Now, before you can go on adding oyster larvae to the downwellers, there's a whole bunch of busy work you need to do. Here, Joe is checking to make sure there are no air pockets before adding the larvae. That would be lethal. We're ready to add the powdered oyster shell. Bet you forgot about our tanks. They should be close to emptying by now. All those dark specks are baby oysters. After our culture tanks have been emptied, Joe's going to make sure that all the detritus and debris gets pushed through the 150 micron sieve. This process may take some time, but this is the last chance to really make sure that you have a clean sample before adding them to your downweller. Once you've added the larvae into the bucket and a set amount of water, Joe will calculate a concentration to ensure the right amount of larvae are put into each downweller. To determine the concentration of oyster larvae, we're going to use this graduated cylinder as a plunger to mix our sample. We will take multiple measurements and record the concentration under a microscope and then take an average. It turns out we have an abundance of oyster larvae, so we're going to select only the largest, healthiest oyster larvae and remove anything less than 230 micron. At this point, we're going to repeat the process, filter the sieve one last time, add our water, and determine a final concentration. And now, the moment you've been waiting for. It's time to fill the system. How many of you would have guessed that there's 50,000 baby oysters in that beaker? Joe and Sam will go on to systematically fill each of the downwellers, and they will do one last check just to make sure there aren't any large air bubbles in the downwellers. Larvae will remain in the oyster hatchery until they reach 2 to 3 millimeters, and now referred to as oyster spat. At that point, they'll be transferred into a flupsy. To find out what is a flupsy and follow these oyster larvae into the field, you'll want to watch this next video.